percent of the world's population live near the coastal area. There is also the coastal activity concentrated in coastal area. Coastal erosion is one of our environmental issues in West Africa.
Okay, go ahead. Okay, in Benin coast, we don't have a long kilometer, the long coastal zone. We have approximately 125 kilometers. But this area is subjected to erosion. As you see in this different picture, so around our coastal area, we have a coastal hazard in Benin, Gangmoon.
Yes, here, as you see the different picture, this is an evidence that Benin is facing the coastal dynamic issue.
Yes, in Benin also we have harbors. We have harbor that, as you know, harbor is in different countries in West Africa. Benin also has, and we can see that here our harbor is somewhere here, and here is the western part of our harbor, and here is the eastern part of our harbor. And we see that we have abrasion at the western part, and at the eastern part we have the coastal erosion. And you see these arrows, the abrasion here, and the shoreline is moving. That means erosion in that part due to the anthropogenic forcing. And also we have also natural forcing like tide, wind, long jaw, drift, and set of different mechanisms that explain what happened.
Yes, this picture just to put the contrast to show that we have a strong erosion in different areas. This is somewhere that we call semi-pruning that we have the sun after the harbors, where we have the sun erosion. And at this part, you see that they construct, they have a kind of infrastructure to protect them. But at the other side, we have a huge destruction of this area. You can go.
Okay, one thing that we are trying to do in Benin since 2013 is the use of the camera system to monitor the hydrodynamic condition. So we have this camera system installed in 2013 in this area. So with this camera system, we have the possibility to have high frequency data. We can have the evolution about shoreline, evolution of bathymetry, wave energy, and different parameters with the sediment transport.
Okay, so this is where the camera is installed. The camera is installed here. We have previously we have this room to process data. So this camera has been installed in 2013. This one in 2018.
Okay, so with the camera system, you have a different type of image. The data, the video can be processed to have this continuous images. This is aggregate data, and this is time stack data that can help to get information about wave heights, about bathymetry and wave severity and so on. Yes, here just to show that we have five kind of images. One is sometimes one average and kind of types. So yes, and also to validate this data of camera system, also perform the field experimental model to validate the camera system. You must know that the camera system is not only in Benin. Yes, can find that about Senegal, Côte d'Ivoire, Senegal here, Côte d'Ivoire, Ghana, Cameroon, Benin, also in this network of the youth of Ghana. Here, I will not spend a lot of time here, but just to show that with the camera system, we can have this parameter, height. Here is showing us the internal longevity of our website from 2013 to 2016, web period, web direction, and shoreline evolution. Also we have the possibility to compute the flux energy of the wave or to have the seasonal variability of the wave. Here also we are comparing the different kind of the parameters of wave height against the shoreline evolution. Here we can put that when we have high variation of wave height, we have a coastal recession. That means we have the ocean in that moment. And this moment is located made from mainly from May to September. That is a period, some period that we have high energy of cold that would lead to high variation. Here is the energy of energy flows, environmental of energy flows. And also with the camera system, we have the possibility to compute the sediment transport. So this, the camera, we were able to estimate the seasonal variability of the sediment transport using this kind of system. Yes, this is also the same information shown here, the wave energy, long-term energy, cross-shore energy, associated with the shoreline evolution. When we have high energy, this is the ocean. So this is what we are trying to show here. And also, with this system, we have also the possibility to compute also the sediment transport. And the sediment transport, here is the profile of sediment transport gas associated with the shoreline. Yes, recently we have installed, because our previous camera had some technical issues, we have installed the version. This is the new one that has been installed recently. Yes, this is a remote sensor scene showing that in Benin, as I said, we have a small coastal region, but we have a different kind of operation in different regions. Some regions that are stable, but those are subjected to high rate of erosion. Here, the harbor is also there, and we can see here that we have attrition. And when we are moving to the other side, we have important coastal erosion. This is just to show that we also use satellite. That is showing that here we have the harbor here and the wave propagation, the wave that are coming as soon around the harbors, and the strong wave that are reached high than 2 meters. Yes, this is how the wave will come, how the wave is coming in this area of our harbors. Yes, and also with the model, this is our model, miner. With the miner model, we can have the possibility to have information about the value of sediment transport. And we see here that if we have havoc here, so we have the lack of sediment along this area. So that is all what I want to present that in Benin. We're able to show the variability in terms of energy, in terms of sediment transport, in terms of shoreline evolution, the wave parameters using the satellite observation. Shoreline evolution is the variation is very important during our summer
And we can say that the cameras, the use of a camera is one of the methods that we can use to study the solid ocean erosion. It's not so expensive, but we have to maintain this system. And also, we have the possibility to use satellite data, even call data to study the ocean.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Frederick. I think we will take maybe questions later. Or we should take some questions.
We can take one.
Yes, let's take one or two questions. Then we move to the next presenter.
Okay, you can ask.
And the online participants, you can write your question in the chat for us to read it for you.
Okay, thank you very much for your presentation. So can you show us the longshot distribution of erosion aggression in the image show based on your satellite analysis? Yes. Just on the west side of the
harbor? We have the bottom accretion here.
Yeah. Then you have erosion on the east side. So this is mainly because of the blocks of sediment transport.
Yes. Exactly. We have drift to drift. Mm. Yes.
But my question is how the erosion occurs on the west side?
Yes. This side we have a Togo. Togo guy also is trying to fight against the coastal erosion, so they have some infrastructure installed. And also the sediment is also blocking on that one.
That's why we have some situation like that. Here is
when our coast starts. So that part is Togo. And they install some infrastructure. So we are having erosion in that part, some situation of stable precipitation. And here is a point we call alcohol. We are having where our camera system is installed. So this is a world satellite show that also we have in that. So here is a ground hole. And here is a where the almost start. And this part is from is benefits the erosion from top this one.
Okay, thank you. So this area highlights the importance of the international sediment.
Yes.
Thank you.
This means all countries should get to find a solution.
Yes. Okay, thank you.
All right, so thank you. No question from the online participants. Okay, one question. Somebody wants to know what software you use for performing the figure in slide 20. 20? Is that slide 20? This is 10, right? So where is slide 20? But I think it's the mic model. Maybe this?
This 20.
Yeah, this is the mic model.
This
mic model.
And this one? So which one?
No, this one is app distributed JAX. Yes.
Okay.
App distributed JAX.
Okay. So you basically use ArcGIS and QGIS and then mic for the wave modeling.
Yeah, mic. We use also QGIS to do tunnel. The border delimitation. Yes, to build the shape file.
Okay, I just explained. All right, thank you so much. So.